Hey guys. Ella, please give me the remote. Bobo, give me the remote. This girl has been so dramatic since this morning. I don't understand. Anyway, I'm trying to lay my edges. That's why I have this scarf on. So, you guys, I've done so much this morning. It's 10:30, and the amount of things that I've achieved this morning, it's a miracle. In my last two vlogs, I told you guys that someone sent me hair and, you know, a gift for Victoria from UK. And she sent it on the 27th of October. In the post details, it said it was supposed to be here 5 to 10 working days. And it is already 7th of December and I've not gotten it. I'm like, this isn't too bright. It's 7th of December and I have not gotten it. So I don't even understand what's going on. I called her, she went back to the post office and they told her that, you know, like what they told her the last time, that once the package leaves London, it can't be tracked. I now realized that I don't think there was any place she filled in my phone number, because I asked her, she said she didn't fill in my phone number, and then I checked the picture of the package she sent me when she was about to post it. There's nothing like a space for phone number, just address. So the way it is now, which I don't think they will even deliver to my house, it probably means it has gotten to a post office somewhere around and they can't call me to come and pick it up. So I want to check a post office not too far away from me. There are two post offices that I usually receive stuff from. So I'll check the one near me here and then I'll go to the one that I did here and check as well. So that's what I'm going to now. It's 10:30 and we also want to check a few houses today. So I'm doing laundry now because they just brought lights. Today is Friday. I always do the children's laundry on Friday. So I'm washing them now and I'm going to spread them before I go. I don't know. I plan to wear like very light makeup. Very, very light makeup. I called my mom so that when I get back, I told her to come around 1:30. Hopefully I'll be back before then so that she can stay with Ella and Victoria for me while myself and my husband go and check the houses. So by the way, you guys, Merry Christmas in advance. This girl is still crying. Merry Christmas in advance. I hope all the things that you wish for come true for you. Really, what I want as a what I want as a Christmas gift is just to get a very nice, good apartment for us. That's what we're looking for. And we're hoping to move out of here before Christmas. Because my sister's wedding is... Yes, darling. Mommy. Yes, baby. Are you worried about? I'm sorry, my love. What happened to you? What happened, baby? Say hi. Say hi. Yeah, say cheese. I know you like cheese. Say cheese. I love you. Again, I just got back from the post office and it was a successful journey. I got my package. I've not opened it. I just said I needed to check in before I open it. So I have hair here and I have a gift for Vicky. Thank you so much, and I'm so grateful. So what happened was that I went to the post office close to me and the man asked me for the tracking number, which I gave him. He wasn't going through on his phone, so he told me I needed to go to Agege, which was where I was actually going to. So luckily for me, he was also going to Agege. I jumped into his car, which is odd. I was like, I need to get this man's plate number just in case. I mean, this is Ember period. But anyway, he took me to Agege. I got there, gave them the tracking number, their ICT person, and they tracked me and found out that I had been in Nigeria since 22nd of October. So they were asking me if I was not in Lagos, and I told them nobody called me, nobody texted me. So I, you know, went here and there, and then I finally, they brought it out, and then they said my phone number wasn't on it. And really, I asked her when she sent it if she included my phone number. She said she wasn't sure. So that was really the issue. That's why I didn't get a message or a call or anything. But thank God I've been able to collect it. I paid 500 naira to collect it, but that's no problem. So I'm home now. The guy actually picked me and dropped me, like, round trip free, which is nice. So let me have my bath. because the roads were very dusty. So I want to bath and then we're going to check the houses. See ya.
Nadine would never do something like that to you. Nadine was perfect.
Thank you for stopping by.
Wait, are you asking me to leave your office?
Before go. Bye. Bye, girl. Can't do this one, no. Because she does the part very well. I love loving a very, very long time. And my picture is looking so crisp. I haven't vlogged in so long because it's been a crazy December, honestly, and I can't wait to get into January. So let me tell you guys what has been going on. I've been documenting for about 2-3 weeks, but I haven't posted any of it. I've been vlogging. It's been easier to vlog, but it's so difficult to compile and then to edit. I have a video, a vlog that I'm thinking of editing today if I have the strength. But it's been a crazy ass December. We are moving from our old house, and man, it's just been, my head is like so jumbled up. So if you look above me there, the AC has been removed. The living room AC has also been removed. So, and the weather is so freaking hot, so you have to just make do with the fan. And it's so annoying because the ACs have been removed for like 3 days now. Every night it's so bloody hot and I'm like, I'm just tired of this thing. Took a lot of things down. We've taken all our frames off the walls. You guys, it's just been crazy. And I wish and I really want to take you guys along with me. So the new place, we paid someone to wash the place. So they've washed the place. But it's still dirty, but you know, it's cleaner than before. They've washed the place and then they're painting. So I'm just coming from there. We took a few things there. It's a lot of work because the house is upstairs. So transporting things, moving things upstairs is a lot of wahala. So the person is there painting now. They said they'll be done painting today or tomorrow morning, and I'm really excited because we are painting with white. Never really wanted white because I have children, but I'm just like, I mean, I really like a home white, and I don't want my children to then make me, you know, restrict myself. So I was like, just go with the white. So practically everywhere is going to be white except Grace's room, which is like a rose pink, and then like the balconies are like cream, and then the guest room is cream. So tomorrow myself and my husband are going to Oshodi Market. We want to buy curtains for the living room, and then we also want to buy curtains for our room, and I also want to buy curtains for Grace. So Grace has curtains now, but I feel like if I find a different design of curtains, I'll buy for her room. I also want to buy plate rack, some kitchen things, yeah. And I'm also excited because I'm buying a ring light. You guys, I'm really excited because I've always wanted to get a ring light, but it just wasn't convenient for me. It's convenient now, and I'm like, oh, I thank you, Jesus. God is amazing. God has been amazing to us this December. Like, a few weeks ago, we wouldn't have thought that we were going to, you know, do the things that we've actually done within this period of time. And, you know, God is just, I don't know how else. Like, telling you guys is not thanking him, but I hope he knows. And I know he can see that I'm so, so grateful for everything. The way things happen in our lives, in my family's life, is like, when we have a huge need coming, a lot of times the things to make those things come to pass are usually not available. Like, we can't even see them even if we use binoculars. So we then start stressing about it. I start stressing about it because my husband is always very chill. The guy is just, let me just blow his trumpet now. My husband is so chill. He's so calm. He has very, very big faith. Like, that man, I can't understand. There are things that you expect to bother him, and he's just like, sometimes I'm like, am I sure this man is even like, yeah, they find solution. Let's say this man not get plan, but he's so chill, even in like the toughest of situations. So a lot of times things are like up to here for us, and we're like, oh my god, how are we going to cross this hurdle? How are we going to do this? How are we going to do that? How is this thing going to work? How are we going to get money to do this thing? And just at the nick, like just when it's getting this close, we just have a breakthrough. It always happens. It's been happening from when we're about to get married. You know, with the bills and everything, we're just like, oh, it's not convenient. Are we going to do this? And it just happened. It's happened now. It happens every time. Even when I want to give birth, want to do a naming ceremony, we're like, oh my god, we need money. And then something just comes. That's what happened now, and I'm so grateful. I'm just so grateful. I'm trying to take you guys along with me, and yeah, hopefully that I do a good job just documenting this whole thing. But yeah, so I'll see you guys. Bye. Begin on my way. I love you, no means it. You say make a good one up for fire, 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 fire. I go go up for fire. You know means it. You say make a good one like for fire, 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 fire. I go go up for fire. You love me, I love you. Shukura kilo kosio, shuku sheka, aya shumeka oke. Paradise is your drama, never need it. For the top of all, I'm down on par. No tear to cause wahala, hello diva, save your drama. For there for me, you for there. Good morning, guys. Focus, honey. Focus. Good morning. Hello. So I'm back. So Grace actually prompted this vlog. I didn't want to vlog today. I'm excited and I'm not that excited at the same time. I'm excited because we're moving out. So if you look behind, you see that we don't have any chairs again, because the carpenter is like redoing our chairs, reforming, they're like changing the frame of the chair, they are putting new foams, and then they are covering them. Hold on, let me be Chris. See how quiet she is after smacking her for being silly. So like I was telling you guys, we're moving out of here. We removed all the frames on the walls. We removed our AC from there. No frames, no chairs. That's all we have. That's all we've been sitting on, because carpenter is like redoing our chairs, like I said before. So our plan for today is that we're taking down the fans. The fans have all been taken down already. So what we're doing today is we're going to Oshodi. We want to buy curtains for practically everywhere. Taking the children today. Once we get back, I'm taking them to my mom's place today. So I even need to pack up their stuff when I get back. So they'll be there like throughout Friday, Saturday, Sunday, so that we can have time to pack and, you know, kind of arrange a bit. So that's what we're doing. So I'll see if I can carry my camera with me just to show you guys. But if I don't, then I'll show you guys tomorrow. We also want to pick up a center table that we want to buy from somewhere not too far. I found them on GG, but I realized that this shop is not that far away from us. So I'm going there. We're going there to pick it up. So I'll see you guys. Yeah. like a big girl. Vegan out takes milk. Vegan out takes formula. This is her second bottle. She has had like a full bottle, so that's like 300 meals at a go. Because I gave her 180 meals first, and then this is 120. So, Vicky, let's drink our meal. See how chubby she is. See her thighs. I just got to the house. This is how it's looking. We just painted. We just got that coffee table from one warehouse like that, not too far from here. So I'm just going to see the other rooms. I'm really excited, honestly. And I like the white walls. Very good for pictures. I like how everything is looking. Back from Oshodi market, and I told you guys we were going to buy curtains. So we got there and I don't know what was going on with like the stores, why they were closed, but many of them were closed. All of them were closed. We went to Bolade Plaza, all of them were closed, but we finally found a seller. And you know, they showed me like an album with like different textures and colors of like curtain materials, and I was like, I don't like any of the materials here. I had one in mind, let me show you guys. I got it from, if you don't follow this page, Beddings and Beyond on Instagram, she's amazing. Like, she's like a Nigerian interior decorator and her jobs are first class. So I saved one of the cuttings, one of like the images that she posted on Instagram. I just saved it because I really wanted to get that color of cutting or something similar, and I also wanted to get that kind of net cutting. So we went there and then I showed it to them and they were showing me different materials. So I was like, it's either you're showing me what I want or I'm just going. You can't do it to benefit you. Like, I don't understand. There's a lot of them do these things. Their shop was closed, but they wanted me to pick from, you know, the materials that were easily within their reach. So I was about to get up and then they went in and then they asked me to come in. So I came in and immediately I got there, I just saw, like, I told the woman that I had an idea of what the material I wanted, but when I see it, I know that I would just know that is it. So once I entered the shop, I just saw this very beautiful gray satin material and it had a little bit of the shine. So I was like, that is just the one I want. This one in my phone doesn't have that shine, but I was like, I know that is what I want. So the children have gone to my mom's house, the three of them, including Vicky, and right now my right breast is so full. I'm already scared because I'm like, my evening is going to be dripping. And if I had met them when we got back, I would have breastfed her, but I didn't meet them, so I might have to just express it. And I hate expressing milk so much. I really hate it. It just seems like a waste because I'm going to express it and pour it away. So, but I'll go there tomorrow. I think I'll go there tomorrow in the afternoon. But tomorrow we have a lot of things to do. Tomorrow we have to install our DSTV. We have to take down our TV, take it there, and also put it on the wall. And then we need to, what else? We need to clean a bit the cabinets. The kitchen cabinets are not clean, so we need to clean them. We need to clean the windows, the nets. Saturday I have like someone's supposed to deliver a TV stand. I also found the person on gg.ng. Gg, you guys need to sponsor one of my videos because I mention you guys a lot for free. I got the seller of Digidos engine. We also bought a coffee table today, and I think I showed you guys in, did I show you? Well, I think it was on my Insta story, but I'll show you guys. You guys will probably definitely see it. So we got a coffee table, and I also got the seller of Digidos engine. So someone is delivering a TV stand on Saturday. I'm also going to be getting my ring light on Saturday. So I'm getting ready to film videos in 2018, so you guys should expect bad videos. So yeah, that's what's happening on Saturday. Basically, so by Saturday we should be done with everything, and then on Sunday we should be ready to move. So no children in the house. I'm kind of enjoying it, and at the same time I'm missing the noise and just missing them in general. So I've just been telling my husband, I'm like, we hardly have time like this to ourselves, because unfortunate that, you know, they had to go when we have so much on our neck. Like, if they had gone when we were free, man, these 3 days we should just go to a hotel and just have the time of our lives. But you know, we're packing and everything, so I think we might go out tonight or tomorrow night. I think it'll be tomorrow night, because the mechanics are fixing our car, so we should go out tomorrow night. I haven't been out in a while. I think the last time I went out with my husband was when I gave birth to Ella. My mother-in-law was around, so I just left Ella in the house, and myself and him went out. We didn't go that far, but we just went to eat, like, you see, and we drank, and then we came back. I think we're going out tomorrow night. I'm excited. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Don't forget, thumbs up, leave me a comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.